Hello, Zero K fans. Welcome to Nano Lids at Dawn. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, and we're going to have exhibition matches tonight. I apologize for the lack of streams the last couple days I should have, like Friday and Saturday. And I also apologize for the lack of streams this coming Friday and Saturday, because I've been very busy these last couple weeks. I should be back to my normal schedule next week. Like, next week should be proper Tuesday, Friday, Saturday, and I realize that that's not normal, but I mentioned in my last cast, Wednesday casts are now Tuesdays, again, going back to Tuesday, but sticking to Friday for that one. Although, Fridays were always kind of lower priority anyway. So Tuesday, Saturday definitely happens. Friday is a bit less likely, but not this week at all. Friday and Saturday are just busy. Next week, the Saturday is probably going to be the tournament, actually. The 1v1 tournament is most likely going to be the Saturday the 26th, because that is the last Saturday of the month. That is typically when tournaments happen. Usually they get organized on the Sunday prior to the last Saturday of the month. So I wouldn't expect anything until the 20th or 19th or so. If the 20th rolls around and no one's announced a tournament, that's a bad sign. Someone forgot to do something, although it's purely voluntary, but yeah, that's normally when it happens. Normally get announced the Sunday prior, so look out for that around the 20th or so and sign up when that comes up. But after that, and actually leading up to that, probably that week as well, I will be considerably more free, I think. But I'm definitely not free this week, apart from today. Without further ado, let's continue the game. So this was a request from DeeDiebs, and against SnuggleBass, who has been starting up a training clan that I'm actually part of. Very nice of them. So yeah, they have that up, so they've basically given advice to people, and at this point it's going to be a matter of playing games and probably getting more advice, and that's really nice to have. It's good to have coaching programs and mentoring programs like that. I'm very appreciative of that, just both for myself personally and as a general community building effort. I'm very glad to see that. So that is SnuggleBase's little project. DeeDiebs is part of that, and I think this might have been a game for SnuggleBase to figure out what DeeDiebs was playing like, how they're playing, what they were doing, mistakes they might have been making, strengths they might have, that sort of thing. Basically, things to focus on. I don't know if this is the case. DeeDiebs just asked me to look at this game, and I decided why not, because that's what I do. Not the only game I'm going to cast today, mind you, I will cast others, but yeah, this was a request, and I tend to honor requests. Tend to, not guaranteed. Anyway, so Cloaky versus Shields, and SnuggleBase being driven away. DeeDiebs making sure SnuggleBase cannot even scout inside the base. Well, SnuggleBase, on the other hand, has not actually had to even contend with any scouting bandits yet, or dirtbags for that matter. They're on the way, but they haven't arrived yet, so SnuggleBase just standing around snug in their base, not really having to worry too much about anything coming in yet. Although they are protecting the south side, and the dirtbags appear to be splitting along both, one along the eastern and one along the southern ramps. I'm cutting out. Okay, that's strange. Great, when this happens. Okay, I'm not sure. Sorry, someone's saying I'm cutting out, which might be, I don't know if they're talking about the audio or the overall stream. Which would be really bad, because I don't like that to happen, because that screws up the recording too and makes the YouTube. But thankfully I was told about that early enough. I think that I fixed it. Anyway. So DeeDiebs does manage to see what's inside SnuggleBase's base. SnuggleBase still not sure what's inside DeeDiebs, but they could probably assume. I'm a bit surprised that DeeDiebs... Okay, there we go. I was about to say, I'm a bit surprised DeeDiebs did not stick that dirtbag in front of the factory. There we go. That's the cheese. Now, where's that terraforming constructor? Okay, it's pretty close. SnuggleBase, why are you not... Okay, they're setting it up. They got the cursor there. It's being taken care of. Just eat that tiny little bit of metal. So DeeDiebs right now actually isn't... They're a bit behind in power and energy, but they're overall about even right now. They've blocked out SnuggleBase's scouting attempts. They've managed to get in a tiny bit of harassment. More so, a tiny bit of annoyance. But at this point, SnuggleBase appears to be setting up a bit of a retaliatory attack here, which should be able to bypass most of the defenses. This area here is going to be a little bit tricky. Once they see the power plants, they'll probably know to go to the north side. But DeeDiebs does have that defense pretty well set up. Now, the north ramp, however, that's totally blocked off. And SnuggleBase appears to be sending a strong force there. DeeDiebs chasing that away, trying to hide their weakness by basically being aggressive on the north side. And that might have worked. I mean, at the very least, the south side hasn't been attacked. Their base hasn't been attacked yet. SnuggleBass is being a little bit... They're trying to be aggressive, but I think they're not entirely sure where they can safely go. Like, where they can attack without losing too many forces in the process. And the thing is, DeeDiebs has basically been buying themselves a ton of time by attacking with those bandits, making sure that SnuggleBase can't just waltz into the north ramp. However, at this point, I think that time has come. SnuggleBase appears to be going towards that ramp, and that will be coming up in a short while. But then again, DeeDiebs with more bandits just to keep SnuggleBase down. What are they buying time for? Let's say just energy construction. Building up their base, getting that set up. Maybe a little bit of expansion. Yeah, they got expansions going. They have Convict going around the map, or at least going around the south side. Trying to set that up, make sure that SnuggleBase is not able to get in and harass them out. But it looks like, are these on fight move? Yeah, they're on fight move, which is generally not a good idea. Raider Micro on fight move does not work especially well. Bandits have a little bit more than get away with, but that bandit did not have to die. In fact, those bandits should have won against the Glaives. The fact that the bandit fight was on fight move caused it to move to the left like that. Like, it caused it to move to this part of the ramp and get killed by the commander. And went completely out of position. Wasn't even going into flank when it should have. Or, for that matter, just all retreating in the same direction. That fight move basically messing up DeeDiebs' plan. That's why micromanagement's there. Anyway, what the... Oh, sorry about that. What the heck? That was weird. Anyway, so SnuggleBase does still have a very strong army. DeeDiebs, unfortunate... Okay, I'm sorry. Something is going on here. Why must it be just a pain so often? Hang on a sec. I apologize. Spring is being a right pain. I don't know if it's necessarily spring or if it's just other stuff being on that's eating up processor time, like Chrome, because Chrome's always a pain. Okay, so it looks like should be... Okay, there we go. Everything seems to be back to normal. Let's get back to the game. And, Mackie, stop bugging me about pronouns. So, as I was saying, SnuggleBase's base is set up. They have a weaker economy. I guess mostly because... because they're going off wind generators, which... Plus 1.2 compared to the plus 2. I mean, it's more cost efficient. But it's also... Also, apparently not helping too much. DeeDiebs does still have the stronger power infrastructure. And they are getting stronger and stronger by the second, really. I mean, the power infrastructure that DeeDiebs has built so far is going to allow them to basically take whatever reclaim. If they win a battle, they just have to win a battle and get a constructor near there. They can pull these glaives... They gotta pull these glaives out, and I think SnuggleBase will probably not fall for it, but... I don't know. It looks like they are. They actually did lose a few glaives, but that was inside of SnuggleBase's territory, which means... that DeeDiebs is going to have to try to reclaim that, or actually pull up harder. They can't reclaim that. They're not going to try to reclaim that. If they do, that's foolish. Although, now that they've gotten rid of a couple more, ooh, these last two glaives. The commander should be able to take care of those glaives, but that's still going to be a bit of a problem. I know SnuggleBase coming in with their commander over along the side. That is a bit of pressure. They've basically got that northeast side. SnuggleBase is the northeast. DeeDiebs still hasn't really taken the southwest. Looks like they lost the... Did they lose... No, maybe not. Doesn't look like it. There must be a dead convict here somewhere, because I don't see where that could have gone. And no, this is where the reclaim and thus the power advantage could really come in handy. I mean, Overdrive's helping it as well, but there's nothing in the factory. There's no one assisting the factory, which is a major mistake. SnuggleBase does have factory assistance, so with the reclaim and everything they have, they're actually getting much stronger production, which is helping them a ton. DeeDiebs is going to fall behind very rapidly if they don't get that production there. They need to get workers on that factory right now, if not sooner. But they haven't done so. SnuggleBase will lose their commander, but even then, with just even the loss of the commander, that's... Okay, that's a thing. But it's not... It's not going to matter. The problem is that DeeDiebs is not using their economy to build units. They're using their economy for nothing, actually. It's starting to excess. We're getting very nearly excess. Where's their worker? They don't have workers in queue. Do they have any convicts in play? Okay, they're building a caretaker, which at this point... Oops. That's what I wanted to see. At this point, that's alright, but not great. Like, it's really not enough. They really need to get... I don't know, they needed more convicts. A convict or two on top of this, just to push the factory while this caretaker is being produced, or just to produce the caretaker faster. Because, I mean, they have enough storage. They could do both right now. But they haven't done so, and that means that SnuggleBase's army is going to be considerably larger. Not to mention that DeeDiebs is focusing a lot on assault units, a little bit on outlaws, but mostly on thugs. Now, Thug Law Ball, while it's not bad against glaives, against this number of glaives, is going to have some serious problems. It's going to die very quickly. I mean, the glaives are going to have massive losses, unless they're positioned properly. A massive glaive like this is not going to work. A nice line move, set up the army well, maybe have some defenses and support. That's going to help out a lot. We're coming in waves, or just using a sharpshooter to get rid of the outlaw, and as a result, the thugs are completely vulnerable, and the glaives can come in and rip them to shreds, because there are nowhere near enough thugs and outlaws. Because DeeDiebs has just now gotten the production they need to actually build that up, and they're focusing that on factory additions. They don't have the units to really support that, so SnuggleBase at this point should be able to just run in. They should just be able to smash, not even smash the defenders, run past them. Go past them. There's plenty of room to go past the defenders. Go around to the side and then come in and tear this apart. Not sure if they're going to do that. I mean, they have the northeast. They got their main base well set up. Overdrive is still being very strong for DeeDiebs, though. They still have the strong power infrastructure that's giving them basically metal parity despite having a smaller amount of map control. They have fewer metal extractors, but they have much more overdrive in their base. And SnuggleBase has almost no energy, relying entirely on power on wind plants, and not really having built that many. Although, that doesn't make sense. That's 14 wind plants? Oh, yeah, actually that's 16 wind... No, that was 15. So yeah. Unfortunately, a little bit subject to the whims of the wind on this map. Which isn't bad wind, but they didn't build very many of the wind generators. That's the one thing that's been a problem for them. And right now, DeeDiebs... That defense, I mean, they have this territory. They don't have their commander. Mind you, their commander has died, apparently. I guess the glaives killed it, but... Sorry, I missed that. But they don't have any workers. That's the thing, this entire time. Now finally getting more convicts. That's the second convict they have in play. I mean, they lost one earlier, but still. There's all this reclaim. There is an obscene amount of reclaim here, and... Yeah, 1,400 metal. Most of that the commander, mind you, but still, that's a lot of reclaim. That is huge. SnuggleBase... is getting reclaim off of what they can. DeeDiebs is not. And while they're still producing more of that gunship plant, not producing so much for the shieldbot factory. Oh, never mind. No, they are pushing the shieldbots. Having only gotten the three... Well, what are they doing with the gunship plant? The three rapiers aren't really that much. 10 minutes into the game, three rapiers isn't great. It's not terrible, but it's not great. I mean, granted, SnuggleBase is focused more on sharpshooters than they are on, say, gremlins or even glaives. But sharpshooters aren't that weak to rapiers. They're weak to bandits and dirtbags. Dirtbags especially. Like, you see sharpshooters, that's when you build a line of dirtbags and use them to figure out where the heck the sharpshooters are. Although DeeDiebs using the bandits for the harassment, just ignoring the sharpshooters, probably not a bad idea either. But still, sharpshooters, if you have a bunch of cheap units that can just decloak them, that works very well. And once again, we're probably going to see, like, DeeDiebs once again on fight move, and that... Fight move is one of those things that 0k gives you that it lets your units not die necessarily in the most silly of ways, but it does mean that the way they do die ends up being even sillier because it's just the game can't micro them as well as a human can. I mean, DeeDiebs didn't take many losses, but still, that was for Bandit versus Glaive with relatively even numbers like that this far in the game, with the numbers that were there. Minorly micro, those bandits should have not died, pretty much. Or very few of them should have died. Not all but four. With more dying in the meantime. So yeah, that is a bit of a complication. Now, SnuggleBase can't easily beat these numbers right now. But that doesn't really matter. That's not the important thing. The important thing is that SnuggleBase... They have Disabling coming in right now. But the important thing overall is that SnuggleBase, basically, whenever they get the economy, they have the production going for them. DeeDiebs has that now. At this point, actually, you know, SnuggleBase has kind of fallen behind pretty hard. DeeDiebs managed to come back stronger than I expected. I know I was pointing out the fight move micro. That was a bit of a weird hyper-defensive reaction, because I imagine that people would point out, oh, well, they're using fight move, the game is microing for them. Well, not necessarily effectively, no. It's sort of microing for them, but not well. But that's beside the point, because SnuggleBass, I mean, they have the reclaim. DeeDiebs is not taking it. That's the biggest thing DeeDiebs is not doing. They have all of this reclaim, and they're taking none of it. How many workers? They just have two workers. They should be building five. Like, get five or six convicts, send them up. That was the important thing I was mentioning before, is that SnuggleBase is actually reclaiming. SnuggleBase actually has the ability to get a massive burst of economy, and they're taking advantage of that, too. Or at least trying to. But that's not something that DeeDiebs has taken advantage of, and DeeDiebs has plenty of room to do that in. Unfortunately, not the best Thunderbird shot. Didn't quite get all the bandits, so DeeDiebs still in a strong position. But yeah, SnuggleBase has all this reclaim. They're going to be able to turn this around with the reclaim, just in terms of production capacity. SnuggleBase, on the other hand, still no reclaim. Like, they just still only have the two convicts, one of which... Are they both working? One of which is idle, right next to reclaim! I'm sorry, I'm harping on this, but it's really important. Once you get into the stage of the game where both sides pretty much have split the map, reclaim is the deciding factor. That is the thing that makes your economy stronger than your opponent's, is how well you're reclaiming. Like, these workers here are the most powerful thing to harass right now. And the fact that DeeDiebs is destroying these bandits, sorry, not these bandits, these conjurers with the bandits, they're losing the bandits, but they're destroying the conjurers, which is not the most even trade, but it does heavily damage SnuggleBase's economy. Because it pressures them into not using these for reclaim, and also kills some of them, so that's even less build power for reclaim. They had 20 metal per second potentially coming in from this field. Now, until they replenish those builders, they only have 10. So that was powerful. That was very powerful, but DeeDiebs is not taking advantage of that power for themselves. Trying to go for the static economy instead, which at plus 1.6, when you consider that there's... with 5 metal per second, there's about 10 minutes worth of economy in this field, alone. Let alone the middle of the map, which DeeDiebs has a pretty strong grip on. Although it's not quite as powerful, but still, there's a lot of metal. There's basically the entire game's worth of metal, of plus 5 metal. And of course, less than that if you go for, but like plus 10, plus 15, you can still have a good 5-10 minutes of that for the entire map. For what DeeDiebs currently controls, there is a lot of metal there. And they have the energy to make it work. They've had the energy to make it work this entire game. SnuggleBase has managed to get the power infrastructure to be in place, but DeeDiebs has had power infrastructure since the beginning of the game. They've had the stronger power, or energy, rather. And I still don't understand what the Rapiers are for. I mean, where are the Razors? Where are the Gremlins? Granted, they wouldn't know where the Gremlins are, but the Gremlins aren't there. And most of the defenders belong to DeeDiebs. I don't understand what's going on here. Why DeeDiebs is not either using the Rapiers, building up the Rapiers, or why they went for the Rapiers in the first place. I mean, it would actually help a lot in this fight. Especially when these Thunderbirds come in here. Like, Rapiers coming in as backup forces for the Glaives, because, I mean, that's what's happening, is SnuggleBase is waiting until the Thunderbirds are recharging, coming in, disabling all, or disarming all the bandits, and then destroying a bunch of the bandits. Sooner or later, some Conjurers are going to come down here and reclaim this entire field, and DeeDiebs is going to get really behind an economy. Because right now, they're slightly ahead. But they're losing loads of bandits, far more than they should. And if the Rapiers were there, it would force SnuggleBase to split up their attention. They have to build some Swifts, and then have to build some more Gremlins, and then Tridents could come in, a couple Tridents could come in from DeeDiebs. They have the economy to make that work. They apply that pressure, but they're not applying the pressure as well as they could be. And that is proving problematic. That was, I think, 24 bandits that were just lost right then. That was a massive assault force, and with SnuggleBase, with the sheer lack of defenses they have in that south ramp, if they had managed to get through that, a few Rapiers had come in to basically save the day, right as that attack occurred, that probably would have closed, if not closed out the game, at least heavily damaged, it could have possibly led to SnuggleBase losing if the bandits managed to get in and destroy a bunch of the economy over here, like get rid of the energy economy, SnuggleBase would have had very little to work with. Because that's their entire energy economy. Well, plus 8 from around outside their base. And unfortunately, DeeDiebs hitting the most well-defended part of the base rather than the least well-defended part of the base, which they tried to attack before. Falling for SnuggleBase's feint, or I guess that was kind of what it was. I mean, I guess they figured, well, SnuggleBase has that south ramp defended because I tried attacking there, it didn't work. So I'll try the eastern side, which is the defended side. And Does DeeDiebs know this? No, they don't necessarily know this. They know this now. Any further attacks on that side are foolishness, but they didn't necessarily know this before. So, cut them that slack. Still, it's worth noting that the south side is the one that's undefended. Okay, Trident's coming in for a little bit of preemptive anti-air. I mean, partly preemptive, partly get rid of the bloody Thunderbirds because they're stuffing every single assault attempt that DeeDiebs is throwing out. I think mostly the latter. But the Thunderbirds aren't really doing much right now. In fact, I think they're... Are they dead? I'm not even sure where they are. I mean, it probably is more preemptive for the Swifts because I'm pretty sure the Thunderbirds died. I might have missed that, but I don't see... Where are they? Nope. It looks like the Thunderbirds are no more. Must have gotten hit by stray bandit shots. Or the Rapiers got them. I don't miss that. I'm sorry, I'm very tired today. But... What is DeeDiebs going to be doing here? Because they've kind of thrown away an easy victory. But they haven't necessarily lost. It's just that they have had positions where they could have been quite advantageous. And they still haven't taken the reclaim. They still have not taken the reclaim? My goodness. They're building a bunch of defenses and still have not taken the reclaim. And they still probably only have two convicts. And one of them is... Oh, okay, they're both building defenses, but still. I'm dealing some damage here, but that's not going to... Oh, that warrior. That hero warrior. That's a hero right there. Why are they attacking the factory? I mean, okay, deal some damage to it, I suppose, but that's not the target. The target of opportunity is that's the wind generators. Go for the power. That is such a big target. Like, wind generators, that is providing an extra 5 metal. That's basically 3 metal spots worth of kills if you can disconnect them, let alone destroy them. Destroying them is even better, but disconnecting them, that is huge. And of course, the reclaim, I mean, there's still some reclaim over here. Which SnuggleBass will get. Provide a minute of reclaim at plus 5. But DeeDiebs has been ahead economically this entire game, and they have not been pressing the advantage that well. I mean, right now they actually need more production here. Like, they need another caretaker or more convicts, or just build stuff from the gunship plant. They have the money. They more than have the money. And if they were to reclaim, they'd have to build even more just to deal with the reclaim if they started reclaiming right now. They reclaim this field, they're already accessing. So yeah, I realize I'm harping on it, but excess is one of those things that, especially when you have the power to make use of it, it's just, there's no reason. There really is no reason. And these glaives will probably, are they going to die? Yeah, they are going to die. They actually don't manage to get the outlaw in time. They managed to get the outlaw, but not really in time. That was fairly economical. But is there a follow-up force? And the answer is, it's kind of out of the way. Maybe. But SnuggleBass is going to be able to build up a decent glaive army before that gets in there, and the warrior is going to be a problem. DeeDiebs attacking north would be the biggest mistake right now, but it looks like DeeDiebs is in fact attacking west. Not as big of a mistake. Still a potential problem, but not as big of a mistake. And got rid of the Thunderbird, which is exactly what they needed to do. I don't believe there are any more Thunderbirds anymore, so it looks like, yep, stuffing the Thunderbird. And DeeDiebs realizing the south ramp is the one that's very undefended. There is the Razor there. That's always kind of nice. But who cares? Razors don't really do much to ground. And DeeDiebs getting lucky on that sharpshooter, but unfortunately, that's not really the threat. The real threat is going to be those glaives. And if the warriors come along that come up the ramp, if they come up the ramp, if they don't come up the ramp, then DeeDiebs is in a really good position right now. Although I'm a bit surprised they aren't trying to hang on the edge of that Razor range. And no, they're attacking north. No, that is not the thing to do. That is very much not the thing to do. Focusing all their attacks on the western side is what they need to do. The north side is a trap. That is designed to basically... I mean, I don't know if SnuggleBass is meaning to design that for DeeDiebs' tendency to try to attack from all angles at once, but it's working against that tendency for sure. Because DeeDiebs has been doing that this entire game. Ever since the very beginning of the game, they've been trying to attack from both sides. They've been trying to do sort of a 50-50 thing, but the problem is that that doesn't work as well in RTS in general, because static defense are just there. So, yeah, they have the south side's open, and they had a fully committed force in that southern side. These Lotuses would probably not have been a problem. But unfortunately, they lost half of their bandits to that western defense. The southern ramp, that's completely open. That killed them. Although now it's being built up. But before, they had a pretty good shot at it before those Lotuses were being built. Because those were being built on reaction. That was just at the end of it. SnuggleBase was building up the Lotuses. And an Athena coming in to probably resurrect everything here. Because why not? There's a massive army of I don't know, it's just... Is it Reclaim? You're not building that for Reclaim, are you? You've got to build that to resurrect. Like, seriously, there's an entire pool. There's a giant mass of... Well, 1,000 metal worth of raiders right here. If you're not resurrecting that, I don't know what you're doing. Nice try on that one, though. The Blastwing. Curious why they're going for the Blastwings right now, though. Okay, there we go. Finally getting some more production here. DeeDiebs finally getting the production they need to build nothing. I'm not sure what they're trying to do with this. They can afford both, and once again, they have a field of reclaim they have not taken yet. That is the main thing holding them back right now. They have not taken that field of reclaim. If they were to take that field of reclaim, they'd be in a very strong position. I mean, 8 rapiers as well, they can pretty easily attack pretty much anywhere but the main base. Like this northeast side here, that can be just destroyed. And that's exactly what DeeDiebs is planning on doing. Taking on that north side. They'll have to be careful how they approach it, and I don't think they're aware of... No, they're aware of that Faraday. They know where it is. I don't know why they're trying to run into it. Don't know why they're having their rapiers commit suicide, but they are. And is SnuggleBase aware of this? Yes, they are. They're fully aware that there are rapiers at their doorstep about to come in and try to destroy the northeast expansion. Looks like they're not too worried about that, though. They are resurrecting, because that's what you do. Bit of a siege from DeeDiebs, which I don't know if I agree with. Not with this army. They don't know about the resurrection coming in, but that's gonna be a problem. And DeeDiebs trying to smash down the front door rather than going around the side, which is kind of what rapiers are good at. I mean, they're flying units. That's what they do. I mean, there's no... Is there a back force coming in here? Okay, it worked, I guess, but that bought time. Like, DeeDiebs can now... Sorry, SnuggleBase can now get in these warriors just to take care of everything. DeeDiebs can't easily work with that, so they're going to have to... Well, actually, they're fast enough. It was quick enough, but still... Unless you have a backup force coming in, there's not necessarily a point to destroying those stag defenses when you have a bunch of stuff behind it you could destroy. Still, good attack. I cannot deny that that was a good attack from DeeDiebs. Taking on SnuggleBase's northeast. But overall, SnuggleBase has been holding... I don't know if SnuggleBase has been holding back, but... They haven't been reclaiming as much as they could have been either. Really. I was harping on DeeDiebs, but yeah, SnuggleBase hasn't been reclaiming that much either. Right now, the res is happening, yes. And they reclaimed before, which is good. But, I don't know, I feel as their glaives weren't working as well as they could have been. The warriors might have been coming out sooner. So DeeDiebs has managed to get out of this. I mean, they had the stronger economy the entire game. I think that's probably the biggest thing that made SnuggleBase not work as well, is that DeeDiebs had an economic advantage this entire game. SnuggleBase probably would have been able to even that up if they had a couple solar plants. Just a couple, like two or three. That would have been able to stabilize their energy economy so that they never went below their metal. Because the wind generators were not giving them as much as they would have needed. And even with the Thunderbird, it looks like DeeDiebs is able to get out of this, but that Athena gets spotted. There we go. The Athenas, both of them are spotted. So now, I mean, not that DeeDiebs wasn't sure that what happened, but still. The only problem, of course, is getting into the base. But DeeDiebs can do that. I mean, they have potentially reclaim if they would actually go through and reclaim. They have all these cranes. I mean, they don't need all the cranes pushing into that factory. They can just get two of them, put them out to just reclaim everything. You have all this reclaim you can work. Actually, not even just that. It's most of the map, really. There's 5,000 metal worth of reclaim. You can build a Strider on the reclaim alone. You can build a Dante on the reclaim alone. Seriously. There's just no excuse. This is a bit more contested, but everything else is DeeDiebs. DeeDiebs owns this map. Pretty much entirely. SnuggleBase right now, I don't know if it's too late. I'm a bit surprised they didn't go for any gremlins, but still. This is a tough position. This is a very tough position right now. I mean, they have enough energy. The Athenas are not a bad choice. They have the energy to do the resurrection. I mean, it costs a bit of metal, but it mostly costs energy. However, even with that, it's still tough. And even with that, they still don't have... Well, they have the resurrected stuff, but they don't have ground-based anti. They don't have things to really deal with rapiers without having to run into tridents, which has been just messing up their entire anti-air game this entire game. But I think at this point it might just be too late. I think at this point, SnuggleBass, not sure what play they could really throw out there. They'd have to throw something out that's really daring. Now, this resurrection play isn't bad. It's a good idea. It's just that I don't know if it's coming in the right timing. What knowledge do they have? They know about some of the forces coming in. They know about this. They have radar around this part of their base, we can see. That's SnuggleBass's radar. But that's... well, that's where the Thunderbird should go. Not sure if they're afraid of the tridents. Though if they could res some of their own, that would be handy. That'd be very handy. They aren't prioritizing any particular item to resurrect, however. No particular unit they're actually trying to resurrect outright. And DeeDiebs, are they finally... they're apparently finally reclaiming? Looks like it. I see reclaim economy. They're finally reclaiming! Reclaiming, in fact, SnuggleBase's commander. About time. Getting into the reclaim game. 20 minutes too late, but hey. They're in anyway. I mean, they've had the economic advantage regardless. And they certainly have had it since the map control's gone all the way over to them. But SnuggleBass... they still have those Thunderbirds. Or Thunderbird, one of them. Because they stun that out. I mean, it's a bit of a sacrifice, but that would open things up and then... I mean, it's going to be a fight of attrition if they want to get back into this game, but I don't know if they're going to be able to hold up for that. They might. And there they go, there's the Thunderbird! Stunned out, well, okay, died halfway through, but still. Stunned out most of them. Stunned out the warriors at the same time, unfortunately, which really rather stops the whole counterattack game. In fact, those outlaws taking out the Athenas as well. Is it just... okay, there's five Athenas right now. That's been SnuggleBase's entire strategy is Athenas. One thing I'm a bit surprised they haven't done, actually, is go into the back of their opponent's base and just drop off something. Not sure what, maybe a couple sides built in the back of their base? Nothing else is really affordable at this point. Although, it would have to be like here. Like, build a couple over here and then... because I don't think DeeDiebs has vision over that. Oh yeah, there's actually radar shadow right here, in fact. Although they have line of sight, but still, yeah, right here would work fairly well. I mean, not that SnuggleBase would necessarily know, but still. I'm a bit surprised they haven't looked around to try to figure out where they'd run into problems, but at this point, this is game. DeeDiebs coming into the final shot. They know it. SnuggleBase hasn't quite accepted it yet, but it's totally the final shot. This is it. I am still surprised that earlier in the game, these wind generators were not targeted very hard. Because that's the one thing that SnuggleBase has actually had to keep them in the game this long has been all of this power. And yeah, I mean, Orphelius is pointing out that this is, as what I pointed out earlier in chat, that this is probably SnuggleBase trying to figure out what DeeDiebs is up to. SnuggleBase is probably holding back a bit because they wanted to know what DeeDiebs was going to do, like how they were going to progress to the late game, if they were going to reclaim, if they're going to set up their energy and how they set that up. Although I'm still surprised SnuggleBase did not build more power plants because they were stalling on energy very hard a lot of the game. It was their bottleneck for production for most of the game. The only time it wasn't was after they lost all map control, which that's the least of your problems at that point. DeeDiebs, on the other hand, it's more just they weren't using their economy advantage enough. They weren't producing as well. I mean, if you look at the metal excess, SnuggleBase near the end started to access more, but DeeDiebs, actually, I know DeeDiebs never really accessed that much. They weren't the most efficient with unit production. Like, SnuggleBase was always way ahead in unit production, but it looks like DeeDiebs never really accessed more than SnuggleBase. It's just that DeeDiebs didn't really access so much as they spent a lot of their money on defenses. They managed to spend it the most efficiently, but they didn't let it go over. Which is a bit of a subtle difference. Because that production, those units, I don't know if they really needed all the defenses they built, but they could have used more units in several of those assaults. And also some things to do with tactics regarding running headlong into a defensive wall. It was there last time, it's going to be there next time. and you might as well go punch through the weak side. But anyway, DeeDiebs did eventually win that, and I mean, at that point, they had been so many opportunities to win, I'm a bit surprised it took them that long, but they did. It would have felt kind of bad if they lost, actually, but hey, you open it up, comebacks can happen, but I don't think SnuggleBass is trying to win. Anyway, now for some games where I'm fairly certain the players are both trying to win, and we're not just trying to see players who are trying to figure out what the other players will do. That was a downloading match. Now let's try some different matches where it's not just players downloading each other, it's actually players who know each other, know that they're each trying to play to win, and are going to be... Well, they're going to be on some new maps. That's the big thing I want to show off right now. There are some new maps, some really beautiful new maps. I'm going to start off with Zed, one I actually mentioned last week that I thought was modeled after a StarCraft map. I'm not as sure anymore. Looks awesome, though. That's going to be between El Torero and Arteries, and that's going to be up in just a moment, so stay tuned.